realized there were so many people out there that needed help and couldn't find it. So that's when I decided I wanted to make change and really help people overcome their difficulties. After years of studying and becoming a fellow membership with a number of organizations, including Public Health Organization and the ACCPH. Our company worked with professionals through the NHS and private sectors since 2014 to design and create something to help people regain their balance in life. And this is where the ISBT therapy was formed. We went on to publish a thesis on ISBT and a toolkit called the Counselor's Guide to Counselling. Using ISBT and CBT to help people overcome their symptoms such as stress, overthinking, anxiety, panic attacks, depression, and many other health issues. This is done by focusing on the symptoms and teaching clients how to manage them better so they can reduce their stress levels. Someone who suffers from relationship issues and someone who suffers from depression due to job loss both have different reasons, but both clients will have similar symptoms. So, we implement ISBT to help overcome those symptoms, such as sleeping issues, eating issues, and negative thinking. Once those symptoms have gone, all that's left is the thought process, and we work with the client using CBT therapy. This will help overcome and manage most mental and physical health conditions. We can use the ISBT app with referrals or our own clients anywhere in the world using a laptop or a tablet. We are able to ask relevant questions and provide in-depth details about issues that clients may face. With a library of 80-plus self-help sheets, these sheets can be discussed in the session, emailed and printed for the client to do at home. We can measure health performance and stress levels each week to really understand the client's needs, from everyday issues to long-term trauma. Our mission, our job, is to help people and save lives, to make a positive difference in people's lives. And this is what motivates us every day.
Session 7, continue on from session 6. I would like you to write down for me on a scale of 1 to 5, 1 being very bad, 5 being very good. How was your week? Any events or issues that have happened, positive or negative? What were they and how did you feel? Please press pause to answer these questions. Jungle. So today I want to talk about events and emotions. So has any events taken place recently that have been quite impactful on your life and well-being? If not, then something that's happened in the past, or it could be something that you've come into therapy for. So I want you to write down the answers for these questions in great detail. I would like you to write down as much as you can, as much as you remembered, and how you feel too. So I want you to write down what happened, and did you recognize any body changes, any mood changes? How did you control these? Did you recognize when you started going back into a negative change? What did you do when you started to notice this? How did you feel about life in general, before or after the event itself? How do you feel about life? What are your positive thoughts on life? Please press pause to answer these questions. Thank you. So the next set of questions are, do you see a difference? How do you feel now compared to your first session? How do you see your problems now compared to before? How are your emotions generally? Please answer these questions in as much detail as you can. Please press pause now to answer these questions. So the next set of questions are, where do you feel the most negative emotion? Is it at home, work, alone, or with people? I want you to write down as much information you can on this and try to find out where your emotions, your negative emotions are coming from, and why do you think they're coming from that situation or place? And when you feel down, is there any physical or mental effect? And why do you think this is? Thank you for writing this information down. I know it's quite a lot and sometimes it can be very emotional and overwhelming. To help offload some of these stresses and symptoms that you may have, I would highly recommend you go out with different people and groups and do different activities, even just a walk in a park. It does make a big difference in boosting positive moods. I want to talk about self-beliefs. Sometimes our self-beliefs are negative because we cannot, and we continue to focus on negative things, and we cannot focus on the positive things in life or what have happened in our lifetime. We forget to focus on these positive things and events. So here are some examples of self-beliefs. I'm no good negatives will be I failed my exams when I was younger. People say I will never amount to anything good. I have hurt other people's feelings. The positives will be I have many years of work experience. I won a game at a funfair. I love taking pictures of nature. I'm unloved negatives will be my parents never said they loved me. My relationships never last long. My friends went out without inviting me. The positives for this would be people say they love me. I'm caring, kind, and a loving person. I have a strong, close relationship. So what do you think your negative beliefs are? And how can you change them into a positive? You need to try and find and focus on positives of every situation. Please press pause to answer these questions. So for your homework for next session, I want you to do a fun activity week. Part of feeling good is about planning and carrying out activities that you enjoy. Try to plan an activity you enjoy once a day, even if it's for 30 minutes. It could be in the morning, afternoon, or evening over the next week. Record how you feel when you complete one of these. Try to include a mix of activities with other people, as well as activities you do on your own. It could be reading, writing, drawing, or dancing. Outdoor activities such as walking, running, going to the gym, or joining a new class. So you will have a set of 7 columns with the dates on the top and morning, afternoon, and evening on the side. Even if it's 1 per day, or it could be once in the morning, afternoon, or evening, it's entirely up to you. Just try to fill this out and try to accomplish all of these things that you have written down. And even if you can't plan ahead, then as the day proceeds and when you do have time, just write something down and try to do it. But try to ensure that you make time for this. So now you're starting to see a difference in your sessions from where you first came in to now. We've gone through thinking patterns, how to be more assertive, how to be stronger, and you're shifting from a negative perspective on things and life to a positive perspective on things and life itself. The solutions should be a little bit more easier and to understand. Your mind should be a little bit lighter, with great more focus in whatever you want to achieve in life too. And this is something that we're also going to be looking in the future, in the next couple of sessions, to just to help maintain and bring a stronger inner and outer well-being for you too. And you have achieved a lot by coming through these sessions, especially to this session now. We've looked at so many things and different aspects in life. And hopefully you start to see the picture being built of who you can really truly be in life, and your life has no limitations, and you should be able to express yourselves and be more confident and be willing to lead your life the way you want it to lead, rather than other people forcing you to live a life that they want you to live. So in our next session, I want to talk about how we can begin to take charge and be in control of your own choices. Also, we will look at how to make positive difference in life and surroundings, and what you can do to live a peaceful and happy lifestyle. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in our next session. Professional use only. Session 7 notes. This session involves looking at any remaining issues, thoughts, or questions the client may have in regards to the last session, and exploring how the client performed in any solution-based tasks discussed in the last session. This session also is about understanding how the client is putting into practice methods or solutions in the client's life and particular issues. This is also a good time to reflect on any remaining issues the client may have. Generally, by this session, the issues tend to be smaller and questions are asked regarding smaller issues, perhaps from a different perspective. The client tends to look at and look back at possible mistakes or ways the client felt could have done things differently. So it is highly recommended you encourage the client to look back in a positive way and use these skills learned to be able to manage future issues and their symptoms better. Self-belief. The self-belief sheet provides a good way to show and make the clients aware of how they are thinking. It helps the client to see how they see themselves and others around them. This teaches the client to be more aware of their own thoughts and feelings. It also helps the client turn each negative thought or solution into a positive thought or solution. The fun activity sheet is homework. This allows the client to be able to make time for themselves. This teaches the client to be more active in doing activities that they like to do. It also helps them to put themselves first when doing physical or mental stimulation activities. This increases physical fitness and mental relaxation. This also helps to manage their day or week effectively. If they're having too many gaps, then they can fill in their gaps with positive activities. And if they're doing too much, they'll be able to try and hopefully reduce these activities and do something that they enjoy to give them a refreshing perspective on the week and their life and be more energized in doing tasks and things that they want to do in life. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in our next session.